Gimme A Break will not be seen tonight, but will return next week at its regular time. Stay tuned now for Remembering Christa McAuliffe, a WSMV For the Family special presentation, brought to you by Cumberland Hall and Kroger.
Never forget them, nor the last time we saw them, this morning, as they prepared for their journey and waved goodbye, and slipped the surly bonds of earth to touch the face of God.
4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff.
On January 28, 1986, an American folk hero boarded the Space Shuttle Challenger to venture forth into space.
Liftoff of the 25th Space Shuttle mission, and it has cleared the tower.
She was high school teacher Christa McAuliffe of Concord, New Hampshire, the first private citizen ever to become an astronaut. She was Concord's pride and joy.
It's very important, especially to a town like Concord that's kind of a sleepy town, even though it's the state capital. Well, she's the first teacher in space. The first teacher, and also a woman. Thank goodness.
Her missions were to reawaken the pioneer spirit in Americans, to encourage children to learn more about space science, to share with us a space odyssey, and to realize her dream come true.
Engines throttling up, 3 engines now at 104%.
Challenger, go at throttle up.
Her dream ended 74 seconds after the shuttle left the Earth. Christa and 6 others perished as the Challenger exploded. This tragedy plunged the nation into a state of shock.
The vehicle apparently exploded.
During the crisis, the president urged all of us not to look back.
It's all part of the process of exploration and discovery. It's all part of taking a chance and expanding man's horizons. The Challenger crew was pulling us into the future, and we'll continue to follow them. Nothing ends here. Our hopes and our journeys continue.
Has spent over a century honing its skills to cut your costs. One supermarket has the buying power of over 1,200 stores. One supermarket can make a difference in your food budget. The supermarket? Kroger. And these cost-cutter scissors mean you get low cost-cutter prices on top-quality national brand products throughout the store. See the difference the cost-cutter scissors make. Go Krogering.
Like ripples in a pond, emotional problems spread, touching family, friends, and others close to the individual. Serenity can return. Emotional problems can be treated. Cumberland Hall can help.
Turn you on to a 99-cent double cheeseburger. Get a delicious flame-broiled double cheeseburger for only 99 cents. But it's for a limited time only.
Where you going?
Burger King.
Get your double cheeseburger for only 99 cents now.
Burger King.
It'll turn you on.
We know how burgers should be.
As the Nashville business community grows, so does the residential community. What was once quiet countryside is now neighborhood. What was once quiet street is now a residential interstate. Are Nashville's growing communities becoming a growing problem? Is it uncontrolled building or constructive growth? Join Channel 4's Jeff McAtee as he examines Nashville's residential boom and how Nashvillians are becoming more involved in the change of their neighborhood. Watch Your Home, Your Future tomorrow on Channel 4 Magazine and A Scene at 6.
What were Christa McAuliffe's roots? Where did she get her extraordinary vitality? How did she become someone whose energy and charm would stand out in a crowd of thousands? Perhaps she was born that way.
She walked early. She talked early.
She was talking and blew a streak when she was about a year and a half.
Christa grew up in Framingham, Massachusetts, the eldest of Ed and Grace Corrigan's five children. Even as a young girl, she was interested in everything.
I liked to get involved in things. I was always involved in my church, and I was involved in Scouts, and I played the piano, and I, you know, took dancing lessons and did all the probably normal things that kids usually do. I was the oldest of five children, so I probably was given a lot more responsibility at a young age.
She was always very confident. She always would do the best she always could do, and she strived to accomplish. And she was just naturally like that all the time.
Esther was a polite, nice child in her home, a very loving child. And she grew up just the same way she was when she was little.
In high school, Christa worked hard and made the ranks of the National Honor Society. She had the talent to do whatever she wanted with her life.
She was good on the stage, she could sing, she liked to draw and paint and all, and we thought maybe she should further go into that type of a career, but she felt that it was a little too iffy.
Instead of a career in the arts, Christa dedicated herself completely to a career teaching children. She married her high school sweetheart, Stephen McAuliffe. They settled in Concord, New Hampshire to raise their family. Steve pursued his profession as a lawyer, and Christa taught in Concord High School and earned a reputation as an extraordinary social studies teacher. A year and a half ago, Christa was one of more than 10,000 teachers who answered President Reagan's call.
Today, I'm directing NASA to begin a search in all of our elementary and secondary schools and to choose as the first citizen passenger in the history of our space program, one of America's finest, a teacher.
Christa had been a talented child, and she stood out as an exceptional teacher. But would she be number one when the White House and NASA could choose any teacher in the land? The answer is already part of American history.
The winner, the teacher who will be going into space, Christa McAuliffe. Where's that you?
I've made 9 wonderful friends over the last 2 weeks. And when that shuttle goes, they might be one body. But there's going to be 10 souls that I'm taking with me. Thank you.
That's great.
I went for something that I felt I had really no chance in. I decided to overextend a bit and fill in an application that I knew thousands and thousands of people were going to be filling in. But it was important for me because it was something that I really wanted to do. And I hope that a lot of students looking at that will say, well, I know 80 people are going to try out for this team, but it's something that I really want to do, and not to be afraid of failure.
What was it about Christa McAuliffe that made her shine brighter than all the other candidates? Christa's ultimate talent was simply that you could trust what she said.
Very sincere, down to earth, and I believe everything that she says. In other words, I believe that she wants to have an impact on education.
Last September, Christa left Concord and flew to Houston, Texas, to begin her training at Johnson Space Center. She literally stepped into the spotlight as a public figure. It was new to her, but she faced the press like an old pro.
If you're used to working with small children, you shouldn't have any trouble with us, so.
I'm used to working with 11th and 12th graders, but you're right.
She met the unfamiliar demands of training with the unstoppable energy and enthusiasm she'd had ever since childhood. Right from the start, she impressed the professional astronauts in her crew.
We're happy to have Christa on board. I think she's an asset to the crew. She sits and listens and then picks the things out that are important and then bases her decisions and everything on what she considers important. So you have to see what the goal of you taking the person to space is. In this case, the goal is to strike the imagination of students all over the country, so you want somebody that's going to do that.
Did you know that Valencia oranges are the best, most expensive juice oranges in the whole world?
Mm-mm. Florida Gold Orange Juice is the only one that's just Valencia.
Did you know that the juice at your house is made with all kinds of oranges?
Mm-mm.
If your mom knew what my mom knew, she'd buy Florida Gold too.
I like an intelligent woman.
Florida Gold brand orange juice. It's not a blend of all kinds of oranges, it's pure Valencia.
Hey, Myron, what's this? Miami Mice?
Just holding on to summer, SB.
But summer's over and we have to get ready for the Snowbird Report.
That's right, Snowbird. You can get the latest on school and community closings here on the Channel 4 Snowbird Report. Brought to you in part by your friends at D.T. McCall & Sons, the professionals at Pointer Osh Optical, and the great people at Office Furniture Warehouse.
And besides, Myron, this beach is already taken.
Jack's placed under police protection after he's named as the only eyewitness to a robbery. Can he crack the crime? Don't miss Three's Company tonight at 10:30 here on 4.
I have browsed every shop from L.A. to D.C., but I like the style of VTV.
Join us on Value Television for information that helps your life work better.
And the products that help you do it best.
Tonight at 12:30.
Christa's months of training drove home to her the importance of her space-age mission to America's school children, to inspire them to study hard and make the most of their opportunities.
The space age is here, and what a lot of kids don't realize is that if they don't get maybe the math, science, or the background, or the writing skills, or the communication skills, they're going to be out of a job. My emphasis is going to be, look what's out there. This is your world. I mean, let's get prepared for it and to get teachers excited about that future.
Even while working for NASA, she remained a school teacher devoted to her children. Her main reason for wanting to go into space was not for herself, but because she wanted to tell the kids of America about her adventures and make them more excited about their own lives and their own future. Last October, as part of her own training, Christa McAuliffe went to Florida to watch a shuttle launch. She was thrilled.
Oh my God, look at it! Oh, it's beautiful!
Christa was devoted to America's space program and to the meaning of her own mission, but her purpose was larger than the teacher in space project could contain. She wanted to inspire not only students, but their teachers as well. She wanted to shed a golden light on the teaching profession and boost the status of her fellow educators.
A lot of teachers are excited this year because for the first time nationally, teachers as a whole group have been recognized as good communicators and people are looking at us in a very positive light. I've never seen people so up for a school year before in my life. And that's wonderful. If you can get teachers feeling good about themselves, if the program did nothing else, I mean, education would be growing by leaps and bounds during this year. And teachers are just really excited about it.
All right, questions we have down here.
Christa had taken on her celebrity status with ease. and she was prepared to step out of the spotlight gracefully once her year with NASA was over. She said teaching had been her life, and she was anxious to get back to her classroom.
I really enjoy teaching, and I feel I do a good job, and that's a good commitment for me. So I do plan on being back in the classroom, and I feel that the Teacher in Space program would lose an awful lot if the teacher never returned to the classroom. I mean, it wouldn't be Teacher in Space anymore. It'd be something totally different. I see myself still as a teacher first, and that's important, and I hope that I keep that perspective, because I do want to return to the classroom, and I think I'm going to be a better teacher because of this experience.
Christa McAuliffe believed that seeing the Earth from space would change her perspective. And as more and more people would go into space, all of humanity might change its perspective.
It might give us an opportunity to see people as people rather than people as part of a particular country. It's going to open that door for a new focus. Rather than focusing on your country, maybe we'll start focusing on this new frontier, looking at the world as a unit. The people, I'm sure, who went to the moon because they were able to see the whole world as this globe came back with a much better perspective of why we all should work together, because we are pretty fragile when you look at the whole universe. So maybe as more and more people get out and get that perspective, things are going to change.
At the core of Christa's approach to life stood the belief that everyone should reach for the stars. Even if your goals seem impossible, you can still achieve them.
There are two maxims I always go by. I say, you know, make sure you're yourself, always be yourself, and always, you know, try your best. I mean, those two things are really important. There's things that I see a lot of times in a classroom that just makes me want to cry, because kids will set such low limits for themselves, and they'll tell you, I can't do that. I can't do that. I'd never be able to do that. No, kids have to push themselves a little bit more. I think it makes them feel good. You know, and they don't have to set themselves very realistic bounds sometimes. You know, it's not a thing that I would say to kids, you know, don't dream. You know, well, you're only a C student in English, so you're never going to be a poet. You know, dreaming's okay. The first time nationally teachers as a whole group have been recognized as good communicators, and people are looking at us in a very positive light. I've never seen people so up for a school year before in my life. And that's wonderful. If you can get teachers feeling good about themselves, if the program did nothing else, I mean, education would be growing by leaps and bounds during this year. And teachers are just really excited about it. I think the science is wonderful that's going on up there, but I'm also very interested in the human element. How are people going to work and live aboard a space station? There are going to be all these countries that are coming together, working as a communal effort on board the space station, and that excites me even more than the scientific discoveries that are going to be happening. Just the thought that Japan and Germany and other countries can actually get together, and they're not duplicating each other's experiments, so they have to share the information. Well, that, to me, is a great step. Much far removed even from the United Nations, that countries have got to work together, and they're working together in this new area, in this new frontier. And as a historian, that's an exciting possibility. One of the things that the astronauts have been looking at, they can look at the different places and find that, for example, over Africa, are there pockets of water that have not been discovered, or are there places that people can move to if you see a desert starting to encroach. And over a period of time, just the geography of the Earth as it's changing, and the weather, being able to, and wouldn't it be nice to be able to have very accurate weather forecasts? I mean, I can see that as coming out of space. But also I can see people looking forward and looking towards maybe travel to Mars or going into the outer reaches of the planets. I think that's going to be, a natural step that's going to be taken. So. It's an exciting thing, and kids love to deal with the future. Kids love to be able to imagine what's going to happen. Kids don't let you sit back and get complacent about life. It's a challenge. You're there all the time, you know, making sure that you know information, or you're able to change your teaching techniques to be able to reach other kids. And you can't get bored in an occupation like that. It's a learning experience every day for me. And I feel that I need to be challenged like that. And it's good. I really couldn't see going into anything else.
What do you see your role as a
teachers, as a group, or communicators? Teachers as a group have been doing this type of thing for years. I mean, for 15 years, I get up and take information and figure out what audience I'm going to reach and how I'm going to best get that information across. And that's what I've been doing for 2 months.
Okay. Whenever a kid is pushed a little bit in my class, either the self-motivation that comes after, you know, my months of nagging or whatever, they feel good because they produce something. And maybe it's not a work, but they produced it. And they should feel good about that.
Just want to get a nice straight ahead shot like that, just with the arms open, just like I had it before. That's good.
Okay.
A little bit wider, real wide. That's good. Real. Can you get them any wider at all? Okay, that's good. Okay, thanks.
Like ripples in a pond, emotional problems spread, touching family, friends, and others close to the individual. Serenity can return. Emotional problems can be treated. Cumberland Hall can help.
Hey, Alex, what's this guarantee business?
Well, Miss Hanson, it means that Kroger now bags all its meat with a double money-back guarantee.
Come on, Alex. Guarantee your meat? Why?
Well, the guarantee that you're always satisfied.
But, Alex, I guarantee that I'm already always satisfied.
See? It's working.
Huh?
We have such confidence in our meat that we can practically guarantee you'll never use our guarantee.
Then why do you have one?
Because we don't need one.
Ah.
See the difference. Go Krogering.
Y107 and Channel 4 take the wraps off the Walt Disney World 15th birthday bash.
And cruise.
I'm Coyote McCloud.
I'm Sharon Puckett. And here's what you can win.
Yo-ho! A trip for four to the Walt Disney World 15th birthday party.
Plus a five-star cruise to the Bahamas on Premier Cruise Lines, the official cruise line of Walt Disney World.
You'll fly Eastern to Orlando.
And stay at the Walt Disney World Resort.
Listen to Y107 and watch Channel 4 Magazine 15th birthday bash details. Whoa!
Talk about crashing a party.
Sort of like a hero. She just, you know, she really set an example. And you just can't help but admire her.
Christa McAuliffe will always be remembered as an inspiration. She was an explorer, never afraid to attempt the unknown.
Everybody in Concord just felt like she was a representative of this town, and that nothing could happen to her. She was invincible, and she was our hero, our local hero.
Myself, like everyone else I talked to, felt a loss, just an empty feeling afterwards. You don't really know why, just a tragedy.
Just saying to me, do you think there'll ever be a time, a day goes by that I won't think about this? And I said, maybe in a couple of months. And what did you say? A
couple of years, maybe.
But what about now? How many times a day do you think about it?
5 to 20.
This thing really stayed with us much longer than we thought. The people would meet each other in the street and say, are you still feeling it? You know, and it was an idea that when expected the grieving process to be something that you go through, and it seemed to be hanging in there a lot.
Ravi Fried and his son Zachary are particularly touched by the loss of Christa. They were with a group from Concord who were at Cape Canaveral when the space shuttle exploded. They recall fond memories.
Here was somebody who represented challenge and adventure and a sense of, help me out, challenge, adventure, and exploration, but at the same time was a mom, a friend.
And trusting.
Trusting.
She was a good mother.
My memories of her are wrapped up with the whole experience of being with the children and the anticipation and what kind of a person she became for us during that period of anticipation and the kind of person she became to us in the middle of the tragedy.
Tragedy made an impact all over the country. Children at the Franklin School in Newton, Massachusetts are learning to transform the disaster into a positive experience.
She was going to be the first non-experienced person to go into space.
Does that make everybody have a dream?
Yeah.
They reached for a dream, and you can reach for a dream too. I bet that right now, if Christa's spirit were in this room, if every astronaut could hear you, they would say, it was worth our doing what we did.
Helping
them. Reach for a dream. Don't just be satisfied to keep your feet in the ground. Try for something.
Like,
you carry on that dream, and that's really important.
If Christa McAuliffe had one thing to share with her fellow man, it would be this: her passion for life.
We remember Christa McAuliffe, who captured the imagination of the entire nation, inspiring us with her pluck, her restless spirit of discovery, a teacher not just to her students, but to an entire people, instilling us all with the excitement of this journey we ride into the future.
Remembering Christa McAuliffe, a WSMV For the Family special presentation, has been brought to you by Cumberland Hall and Kroger.